How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Pathway. We will pursue a new adventure. I guess I could try and do the same thing again with, you know, increased difficulty or anything like that, but I would much rather advance to the next proper adventure and see what waits for us there. The Wrath of God. Jerusalem, Palestine. Morton was quite right. The Nazis are up to something sinister. That's why you're hot on the heels of a German expedition to Mount Ararat. Or are those O's? They are A's. They're searching for a mysterious object known as the Wrath of God. Foil their plans. Well, okay, but is that the object, or is it just a thing that they potentially will be encountering if they choose to pursue this folly? So we've had Miguel and Piranha, as he's much more famously known. We've had these guys manage to survive their respective expeditions. So they're kind of battle-tested a little bit. I could try and level them up, but at the same time, maybe I'm better off trying something new. I don't know if bringing a healer is worthwhile in only a two-person mission, but at the same time, I do keep dying. But I think having two support characters, like this repair dude and a healer together, would be a terrible combo. So even though they're the two I haven't used, that's not what I'm going to go for. Repair kits are for restoring armor, so it's kind of like having a healer, but I guess it would matter more when you're using a character that has more armor. So like, he actually doesn't have a ton of armor, so sending the repair guy with him is probably not great. Well, let's give Natalya a shot. She's excited. She's pumped to get out there. Cool. She's earned her place in this party, I would say. So I can upgrade to quite a lot here. Way better damage, a bit better accuracy, crit chance, crit damage, and no real negatives there. So yeah, I think you're going to go ahead and take that with you. And you, if you carry like pistols around and stuff, ooh, lesser range. But honestly, if she's mostly a healer, I want to make sure she's as like set as possible by having like a strong, workable, worthwhile weapon to go along with. So that's part of why I want to take her along. You should just take that rather than me walking around with it. We can sell this shit, can't we? Yeah, let's just remove these crappy weapons. I don't think you'll ever lose your weapons or your loadout or anything like that. So if you don't need it anymore, you might as well just send it to your valuables to be converted into cash. I think that's totally fine. Every weapon and armor type has a unique special ability that can make the difference between success and failure.
Your vantage point on the hill provides an excellent view of the heights and valleys of Palestine. A large cloud of dust on the dirt track below marks out a large German convoy.
Man, there is an actor that reminds me of so much. I said Harrison before, and that's just because it has a little bit of that, like, sauciness to it, and it's like a confident, cool guy voice. But there is an actor that sounds almost exactly like. It's a very, very good fit for the game. I really do like that narrator. I almost wish we got to hear more from him. This is quite a sizable distance that we have to cover. We still only start with the 10 fuel. Who knows, maybe I break this one up into two parts. We'll see how the hell it goes. You gun your engine. You have no intention of losing the race for the Wrath of God. You gun your engine. You gun it? Like, you know, you gun it. Pedal to the metal. For a second, it made it sound like you were shooting your own engine or something. It was not clear. You meet a few goat herds camped around a small well. You attempt to communicate using signs and gestures. The nomads look at you with interest, but they don't understand you. So onward we go. What are the chances that Jackson and Natalya are going to hook up? They'll fall in love. A row of speared skulls make you stop your jeep. That might make me keep going. That's to each their own, I guess. After a few minutes, you have satisfied your curiosity and continue your travels. Really? That was just a matter of curiosity? You just wanted to take a quick gander? You feel good about it after that? Shoot, there is... Hey, a person. We should definitely try and make it to that. There's only like one shop and it's at the very end. Should probably try and make it to the settlement thing. that's a lot of, like, you would have to go quite a bit out of the way, backtrack, and then cut across to that. Is there any way of making that in that particular one? Oh, there's no even connection there. You would have to go out this way now. It is, by my count, impossible to make it to the person on a current fuel supply, so it's gonna take a bit of gambling. I'm gonna cut off to the side here, as curious as I am about that, because my best chances of making it to the person, or whatever, is up that way. You spot a small troop of German soldiers. If it's a small troop, I'm just gonna get in there and fight and try and hopefully steal some fuel or something. Yeah, I feel like it's gonna be too easy to get caught completely fuelless as is. So let's just try and do what we can, shall we? Maybe you guys are best kept separated to a degree. I'm not sure how like tight knit to keep the group or anything. I'll position them slightly apart and see how that goes. Regular old shot. Well done, old bean. I'd say just reload. Let her take her shot and hopefully just be done with this one guy right away. Don't take it the wrong way and use medkit. Right, she actually has... So that can be exhausted. Same as ammo, same as grenades, all that. You do still have to be like mindful of how you're spending things like that. Right, I forgot to end turn. I'd say we... Didn't think he would have such a long distance shot like that. I gotta start paying attention to like... what kind of weapons troopers carry and things like this, so I know like more precisely where they're capable of shooting from and all that. I think I'm just gonna run up here and stab him. That seems like a pretty ballsy move. Dang. Well, she can still land a shot from there, so that's fine. I'll let her come in and finish things off there. Pretty good teamwork. You guys are gonna bang for sure. All this tension of the danger, these near misses, the adrenaline of taking a man's life. Of course they're gonna hook up by the end of it, right? Is there like a backstab bonus or anything like that? I don't know. Still does 30, just 30 every time, huh? Well, do you know what? You might as well get a bit of blood on your hands too. I need to learn how much a punch does. 10. Honestly, that's better than I expected. I was willing to risk that it would do like 2 damage or whatever, but I had to learn that eventually. So it seemed worthwhile to run in and do a quick dispatch there. Good job, Natalya. She got all 3 kills there. What a killer instinct she's got. Pretty crappy knife and fuel. There's at least that. We're back up to 10 again. So that's pretty okay, actually. I do want to take a quick look, actually. Is that knife better than what anyone has? Oh, that might be better than his crappy stiletto. The crit damage is worse, but everything else about it is decently better. Equip, please. I potentially could have, like, one-shotted those guys with that knife if I would have had it. So I think that's worth switching over to. Let me map out a new path here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That is the one we're taking then. Because even if I find no more fuel, at the very least I'll find out what happens when you go to like a person square. You stop and look at cactuses. That's the most boring way you guys could have spent your time. I've always rested. Oh, do you know what? Do you only find rest stops when the day is growing late, or is it totally random? Because like the day is being exhausted. I don't think I've ever run out an entire day because I've always like just naturally by playing, so I've always stopped and rested. P.S. I think I read that there's something like 400 of these random events, so now and again you get slight repeats or similarities or whatever, but there's a lot of unique ones. You're racing along the gravel track at the full speed, and enjoying cool wind, switch that the around, it got borrowed, on your face when a loud bang breaks the monotonous sound of the engine. At first you think it's a gunshot, but as your Jeep starts to skid, you realize you have a flat tire. Crap! With some difficulty, you bring the car to a halt so you can take a closer look at the damage. You're going to have to change the wheel. You take the opportunity to re-tighten all the screws on your wheels before restarting your journey. Oh! You guys got experience for that? Yes? So it would seem? Or is that just from the previous battle or whatever? That seemed to not really trouble me in any real way. I'm fine. Oh, damage taken when you're moving on foot is dependent on each individual's endurance. So that was how the damage was calculated the time I had to walk through the desert. Oh, if you find fuel, you can keep going. You don't necessarily need to return to the Jeep. Doesn't really say anything about time of day, which is initially what I was looking up. Ooh, I can investigate individual enemies here and learn a little bit more about what they actually are armed with and things like that. So that's quite useful for me. Just a few simple things I decided to brush up on. A lot of the game is very intuitive. I like don't really need to read up on the tutorial. And I'm kind of glad the game is like, if you feel like you need an explanation, here it is. They don't force you through some monotonous tutorial or anything. As you take a short break at the edge of the track, the strange humming sound fills the air. You decide to get to the bottom of the matter and follow the sound as it grows increasingly intense. Maybe it's some El Vibrato? As you climb a dune ridge, you feel as if every fiber of your being is vibrating in resonance with the humming. From the crest of the dune, you see a deep depression in the sand. At its center is a huge, pitch-black monolith among some strange rock formations. The humming seems to emanate from the strange object. You soon reach the foot of the monolith. Once there, you experience almost total silence, but the air feels like it is electrified. Sixth sense. Crap, it's not even always the same investigative things when it seems like all you need to do is kind of like look thoroughly. So I never know what character to bring along. It's totally random what things you're going to encounter anyways, but if it was like very common to find something that just requires one perk, then just take that guy with you. But they must have purposely made it so it requires a balance of things. As you circle the area, the humming returns to full volume as soon as you are a few steps from the monolith. However, apart from this discovery, you find nothing that indicates the function or significance of the monument. Shit! As you're about to embark on your journey, another sound reaches your ears. Engines! You quickly climb to the ridge of the dune. Two German army jeeps are approaching your position. You look at each other in alarm. You still have a good chance of escaping unseen. Ooh. Prepare an ambush. Secretly observe. Let's try and ambush him. I just want to see what happens, if we gain some sort of advantage or something like that. Seems like it would be cool. Hopefully, there's not too many enemies. It did say a couple jeeps. I should have anticipated that it would be something like four. Oh, we're battling around the monolith, which is kind of cool. Where the hell are they, though? Oh, they're all geared up at the top there. Okay. I say we play things relatively safe at a distance from way back where we can. I'll get you. There's not good cover opportunities, is there? So I'm gonna get you to hang back here, and I'll run you forward when, like, the opportunity presents itself. So from here, it wouldn't be a hit. I have to come out a little bit. In that case, honestly, my best bet is pretty much to just hunker down. I think I'm just gonna hunker. And what about you, though? I could also find a better position for yourself. It's all just a bunch of half covers. Well, whatever. We'll let them come to us, and then we'll plan our next move. Because if they start crawling on down, then maybe we can pick them off. If they leave themselves spread out enough. Ah, that guy does have armor. Maybe I just try and... Oh, well, if he's coming for it, then I guess the big guy is the one I'm going for first. I didn't get much of a choice, did I? Attacks two targets in rapid succession. I can't use it twice on one guy. That's not a specific option, because that's what I would very much like to do. I could take the cover here and take like a double or a big easy shot. Burst fire, that's the thing that lets you shoot two guys. I did upgrade his knife. So let's go for some sweet knife skills. And we're going to use some bravery for the bleed. So if you can't manage to get the killing shot off, which I think you should be able to, and I don't think that's an... Like, 15 damage of bleed, I don't think is going to happen. You still have 100% of the kills there, Natalya. You're a machine. You're a monster out there. Ravenous. No one's going to want to mess with you. Shit. Well, this is the first one to want to mess with you. Oh, right. I forgot that she, like, just doesn't have much armor or health or anything. Wow. That was a devastating amount of damage to take, actually. That's not good. Can you still attack? Where can I place you where you can still get an attack off? Shit. That's not good. Do you know what? Knife. Perfect. Kill 10 enemies with a single shot. It's an achievement. Boom. Crushing it out there. But I need you to go take some, like, cover. Majorly. Please. Look after yourself. Medkit heals 20. I think you just have to do it now. So, you know, there's no point waiting till you're at, like, zero health. I know you, like, quote-unquote, lose 3 of that, like, healing potential or whatever, but that's fine. It's a trade-off that needed to be made this particular time around. Can I just go full Rambo and just keep running around and knifing people? Because that's what I'm gonna do. That's what I want to do. Aw, nuts. Okay, where can I place you that you can still get a shot? Where can I place you where you can get a shot that's likely, most likely to hit? Because he's super exposed right now. That's 40%. I was worried that it wouldn't be great. 32 damage. That did more than I realized. I forgot I gave you that upgraded pistol. All right. Yeah, of course you'd miss. Now guess what's going to happen. Knife is going to happen. Is that what you were going to guess? Because it's the obvious answer when you think about it. You obviously just hadn't thought about it very hard. That one went down quickly. Hey, finally, Jackson, he's got some kills of his own here. He's pulling his weight in this expedition here. Not leaving it all up to Natalya every possible corner. All right. A Adler and Stalgnecht, which I don't think will... It's not that great. Cash, just straight up a neat bundle of cash. I got a lot of money I'm sitting on. And more fuel. That was part of the motivation for, like, taking that on. Oh, did I count this out properly before? I don't know if I fully realized how... I may have misinterpreted how the paths branched. Now I have the extra fuel, so I should be able to make it to that, like, recruit spot or whatever it is either way, but, you know, it'll be a little trickier. Use some parched trees and wiry bushes. Sweet. We have a ton of money. We can buy all the fuel in the world. He's a guy who's ill-tempered and he's standing next to a thing. Aw, give me your fuel then. If you're not going to use it, I very much would like it. Please. Just go ahead and sell that. I don't need it whatsoever. Ammo... Ammo's decently expensive, all things considered. Yeah, I want 2 compression bandages. I'm gonna really take as much of that as I can. An ammo box, I guess. Oh, that gave me more ammo than I expected. I was scared it was only gonna give me enough to reload your average magazine. So it must be like 6 or something. I didn't look very precisely. I am going to clean out your fuel. Maybe that's excessive, but that's possibly enough to get me to the end. It'll be close. We'll push it. Push it full steam and see if we can make it. Oh, it's the sick camel thing that we had last time. But this time I actually have a healer. We can help this dude. Get in there, Natalya. That's awesome. Finally, I can respond appropriately to, like, an event. She takes a look at the sick animal. She scratches her head, grabs a handful of tablets from her case, and feeds them to the animal. The camel starts to improve visibly after just a short time. Yeah, once the fever has passed, it's already too late. the Camel Whisperer. The herdsman is overjoyed and invites you into his house. You share a hearty feast. After your meal, you oil your weapons and check the rest of your equipment before taking leave of your host. All that stuff is all replenished and everything like that. That's awesome. And we got that experience. You guys are leveled up now. They might have leveled up in the like event before then even. Sick. So what am I going to get you, Jackson? What could you use? A assault rifle magazine size improvement, accuracy improvement, or knife crit chance improvement. Ooh. I do like knifing. The extra magazine size sounds real sweet. I think I'm going to pick that one up. Who knows? Maybe I regret that down the line or whatever. For now, that seems very excellent. A agility stat bonus, dexterity, or reflexes. So let's see. Agility, determine how far the character can move. Dexterity is, here we go, means your character has better aim and improved hit probabilities, and reflexes, evade chance. Every attack against the character has a small chance of evading. I think I'm going to go with moving more. I kind of seem to have been relying heavily on really sprinting my characters around the map like as much as possible. I need to conserve my money, because when I get to that character up there, they're probably going to have to be paid to join the team. That's what I'm like assuming is going on there. As you drive around the next dune, you meet a fully loaded war mech truck coming the other way. The truck makes a U-turn in a frantic attempt to escape. Follow, take up the chase. What's the difference? Daredevil. This option uses a character perk. It may yield a positive or negative outcome. Your perk will, however, improve the chances of success significantly. I think I did see in the codex here that it was like perks and skills, event outcomes. As a rule of thumb, the probability of success for these perk decisions is always higher than for the standard option. So I think this playing out is better than like the standard thing, right? That's my basic interpretation of that. So I think the Daredevil option is like the better choice. You put your foot down and race after the escaping soldiers. You continue to close the distance until you are finally neck to neck with the Germans. Without a second thought, Jackson leaps from your speeding Jeep into the enemy vehicle, grabbing the driver's wheel. That's hardcore, dude. After a short but desperate struggle, the war mech truck trundles to a stop. The Germans jump out and take cover in some ruins. Well, that was epic and everything, but I still have to do the fight? I was kind of hoping that I would get a stronger benefit from all this. I still got to fight these fools. They're all positioned over on that side, hey? Well, a wall. Yeah. Those initial placements are always hard to determine exactly how you want to utilize them. I kind of prefer the I'm going to hang back and let them do their thing strategy. Yeah, there's a better spot for you, actually. Because I don't really know what they're going to do. I can't predict these crazy fools. I just want to stay in good cover and not get blasted to bits. So running in when all three of them are in one spot seems like the exposure and risk there is ridiculous. Whereas the AI is kind of going to spread these guys out a little bit. Oh, so this time they got lumped up a little bit more maybe than I was expecting. See, and then that guy, he just essentially took himself out of the equation for the next minute or whatever. So that's fine. 40%. If I go to the edge here, though, I might be able to do my burst dealy. From here, I for sure can do it. I'm gonna play around with it. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do the double shot. Seems cool. And 100% on this dude. Bam, bam! So it didn't go that great. But still, it was cool. They're not close enough together to do my burst thing. So instead, regular range shot, 52%. Not even that great, but perfect. Okay, I'm very glad that worked out. And, we could just low profile it. That other guy's coming around from the bottom side there, so I kind of worry what he's got, what he's cooking up. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, God, I thought he was going to go shoot after her. You've put me in quite the pickle, honestly. My best bet is going to be to run backwards this way, I think. Yeah, I can get her further away from this guy than I can get her further away from that guy. Oh, but the map kind of ends over there, doesn't it? Alright, how far can you run? Where can you run to? That's a pretty good little hiding spot, I guess. I'm gonna expose... Oh, you have taken more damage than I've realized. This is not going so great, is it? I thought it was going much better than this. In this case, you take your cover here and knife this fool. Oh, that was a critical. That was the exclamation mark. Meant critical. I can probably safely assume. And that's a pretty good cover spot for you there. And you can do a quick bit of patchwork. Could have healed yourself just as easily, but... I don't know, man. You're both injured. Shit. Where is he going? Oh, that was... Your first mistake was exposing yourself... Whoops. To the knife. The knife is unstoppable. Ah, damn, he stopped it. Okay, but do you know what's even less stoppable than the knife? A solid punch. Punch him in the balls. It doesn't say that specifically, but I think we can safely assume that's what took place during that little encounter there. We wrangled them right off their jeep, right? Presumably we can steal a bit of fuel from this at the very least. Not exciting. More ammo. That's good. Hey, an intact monocle. I'll take it. That's a crap-ass... sniper, though. You're getting cut. Do I spend this now? Or this? Heal. Yeah, do you know what? Use on Natalya, just in case it comes up. Restore 100 HP. You gain bandages for that. Cool. Right, I always forget to just drag it. There you go. Now you got that accessible for yourself. Done. I'm feeling pretty good about how we're cruising on along things here. Look how much ground we covered. We got a decent amount left to go. We're going to try and hit up this recruit along the way. I think I'm going to put things on hold here. Next time we'll finish off this particular campaign. I'm feeling good enough that these guys leveled up. They're in full health. They have no armor. Who cares about armor? Doesn't matter whatsoever. Completely unnecessary. Yeah, we'll just assume that we'll never lose. And that we'll be able to finish it in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you again soon.